Can we do it again, sir, today?
Yeah, we will do it.
Last part, yeah.
Last part. That importing that pivot table.
Yeah, in the
Excel file
in the
into
tablet.
The table.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay, by that time, what I will do? I'll send some files to you. Download it and keep it. Even keep this file also. We're going to work on this file also for the module one. Let me share the module one question and answers also. Answers, questions. Same. Papers are right. Shall we start? Okay, last class, we have completed all these things. And we are about to complete this, what is data visualization and what is Tableau software. And we have downloaded the Tableau software also. Okay, now, have everyone having this file? What is the file name? Pivot table. Or else once again, let me send you that file in the group.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me, ma.
So your voice is like very feeble.
Okay, 1 second. Put your voice in the earphone. Let me change it to headset. Sir. Yes, I think I'm not admin now. Let me check it out. Okay, 1 second, first let me check the headphone. Okay. Let's do it.
Excuse me, sir.
now.
Excuse me.
Yes, tell me now.
One second. I'm not added the group, sir.
You're not added in the group, sir. Your number?
Just a second.
So I can't able to add, but I'll tell them to add.
Okay, sir, I have already sent it.
Already sent it, I saw some number. You're from Pune, something, that number, right?
No, sir. It's Neha Lubna. I have sent the contact.
Okay, one second. To whom you sent the contact? It's there, Amma. Let me see. I'm admin. Okay, it's not. Yeah, I told them within a few minutes it will be added, not a problem. Okay, now my voice is clear.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
So let's start. Okay, have you downloaded the file? And who are not in the group, let me post once again from our chat box. Wait a minute. There's one. And we are going to use many files, but I'll be keep on sending. The first one, just we'll go revise on the previous class, the Tableau pivot table. And the second one, sample superstore.xls. So that is for module one exercise file. I'll be telling at the end of the class today what is that exercise and what you have to do and how you have to submit and all assignment. Okay. So now someone is asking that let's go once previous class that practical, right? Okay. So open your Tableau application. Have you opened?
Sir.
Yes, tell me, ma. Hello?
Yes, sir, we have opened.
We opened. Okay. So on the left side, can you see? To a file. So where I'm going to import. Where I can import a Excel file, where I can import a text file, JSON file, Microsoft Access file, PDF file, spatial file, statistical file. Okay. Now, what type of file I sent you? What I sent you, right? It's an Excel file, right?
Excel.
Yeah. Just click on that Microsoft Excel. Okay. Browse for the document. So you may be having in the downloads. If you have downloaded, just try it in the downloads and select that file, which is tableaupivot.xlsx. And just click on open. So now automatically. One second, tell me, ma. Hello?
Send it today. So yesterday one file or today one? One
yesterday's one file or the Tableau pivot what I sent yesterday, right?
This
this file Tableau pivot. So the one more file superstore sample superstore file we'll do later. Just now import that Tableau pivot Excel sheet. Imported. So once the file is imported, so automatically the Excel file will be converted into query with the help of which tool? Can anyone tell me with the help of which tool that Excel has been? Yeah, very good. Excellent.
ETL.
Excellent. Very good. Excellent. So ETL, what that ETL stands for?
Extracting transform load.
Yeah, excellent. So that is what. So ETL using the ETL tool, it has been extracted and loaded into a query format in our Tableau software, right? So what is this as tag means here? This one. So here, what all the data are imported, right? Can you see that columns wise here it is imported?
This is nothing but like integers, numbers, hashtag. Okay. And this is ABC, it's a text content containing column. And this is also some of text containing column. And this is also some integer containing column here. And this is a date containing column, date or time. Okay. And this is a country or region. So can you see this, all this field here? Is it visible to you here?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So suppose if you think, no, sir, actually this is not text. I want to make it as numbers or something, other things. You can click on this arrow mark. Can you see a small arrow mark here? Just click on this. You can just make it however you want here. So not just arrow mark, just click on this hashtag here. See, what is this hashtag? It says, this is whole number. By default, it has been set here. On the right side, this is string. By default, it has been set as string. If you want to change it, you can change it. And here also, by default, string. And by default, it's a whole number. And by default, it's a date. And here you click, and it is by default string, but actually it's based on what? Global things, country and region, geographic role. Okay, so now see here, are you all in this screen? And can you see something called us here? Connections, live and extract.
Yes.
Once if you import that Excel, then only you will be getting these two options, live and extract. So live means, I told in the last class, right? Anyone remember that, what is live? What is live? Anyone remember that? So live is nothing but, see, I'll be working in the Excel simultaneously in the background. If I make some changes in the Excel, and once if I do refresh here after importing the same Excel file inside the Tableau, if I refresh here, automatically here also the values will be get changed. Once if I change there, automatically here also it will be changed when I'm working with live connections. Okay, so what happens actually, just I'll give a small explanation here. We will see brief on forward afterward. Okay, so what happens in the live connection, I'm importing a Excel file to Tableau, right? So directly I'll be having connection with this Excel file and Tableau. When I make something changes in this Excel, and if I do refresh in Tableau, automatically the changes will be updated in the Tableau software. And what is that extract means? I'm importing the Excel file, but before importing into the Tableau software, it will be stored in a place called as TDL. So TDL, TDE, Tableau Data Extract, or and we can sometimes, you can say TDL also, load also we can say, not a problem in that, TDE or TDL, and then it goes to Tableau. So what happens, whatever the data I'm loading and I'm using extract here, okay, when I import some Excel file, the Excel file data will not be directly imported to Tableau. So it will be bring to a place called as TD or TDL. Okay, there one database will be created. Means there once our data will be stored and then it will be imported into Tableau. One extracted file will be stored in a place that is called as TD. One database will be there. There will be no direct connection. In between, somebody will hold the data. Some other person are there to hold that and to transform the data for Tableau. In between, we are having a person here who extract that and stores and then sells to the Tableau software. Is that clear, this connection thing?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, now left side, you see, what we are importing is Tableau pivot. So the Tableau pivot have one sheet, and sheet name is nothing but this one. Inside the sheet, whatever the first sheet has, the content here is the name of this Excel sheet. Let me open this one. Okay, now here this is the sheet, right? Sheet one, and this is the range. The entire range has been imported as query by name sheet one as a table or query inside the Tableau here. On the right side, can you see here view options, view data options here? Just you can click on this view data and you can verify is that exact data what I imported are right or wrong. Can you see what are the data are there? Category, country, date, product, amount, and order ID. And I'm having totally how many rows? 213 rows. And then finally come bottom. See here, you have something called a sheet one. Just click on the sheet one. Once you click on the sheet one, you are entered into this screen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, good. So now let me ask some question. Show me the amount exported to the countries. Show me the amount exported to all countries. So now I want to show how much amount are exported for all the countries, means amount exported for the countries. So first on the left side, can you see two places? Dimensions and measures. So here, which one is called as dimension and which one is called as measure? Can anyone tell me? The left side, I think last class I told that.
Dimensions is category.
Yeah, very good. Dimension is nothing but called as what? Category. And bottom is there nothing but called as what? Measure, right? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. So now what you do, just I'll guide you. You do that. So tell me the result, how it is coming. So before that, let me give a small note. One second. Where is the notepad already we have, right? Okay, let me take this one. I have a note. Dimension is nothing but diamonds are independent variables. Dimensions are independent variables, and we can mesh, we can't summarize. Yes. Is the data, and then third one, sometime numbers like order ID and sometime like order IDs. And employee IDs can be considered as dimension also sometimes, because it can't recognize under measures. Okay. So now, see, from the dimensions, please take this country and drag and drop into that this place. Done. So now can you see executing query, it is coming. So where in the back end Visqul is running. So where Visqul is helping us to convert that dimension into visualization format. Are you getting that one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now next, what is my question? So now we have done with the dimensions. So amount will comes on measure or dimension? Amount comes under measure or dimension, ma?
Measure.
Very good. What is measure? Measure is nothing but dependent variable. And this can be grouped by dimension. Measures can be grouped by dimension and it summarizes or it aggregates. Which one? Measures summarize the data or it aggregates. Aggregate. Or it aggregate. Okay. So dimensions are independent variables. Okay, and we can't summarize the data, and sometimes numbers like order ID, employed ID can be considered as dimensions because we can't group that. Can we group that employee ID and order ID? Anyone can tell me? Is it possible to group employee IDs or order IDs? We can't write. So that is why sometimes this can be considered as dimension. And measures means, okay, this is dependent variable. This can be grouped by the dimension. With the help of the dimension only, this will be grouped and it is used to summarize or aggregate the values. So now where I loaded the country here, and then what I have to load here? Amount. Okay, on the right side, can you see something called as show me? Just click on the show me. Can you see automatically Visqul, which is running in the back of our Tableau, which is very, very important for Tableau software, that is running, which is back end of our Tableau software, Visqul. So that automatically creates a visualization, which is nothing but called as here show me. You can change the different maps here. You're getting this? So let me select this one. Now can you see this, ma? You're on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now for you, can you able to see which country? Can you tell me which country is this? Okay. Okay, the blue, dark blue one. Can you tell me which country it is?
United States.
Oh. You're showing, means you're keeping the cursor and telling, or blankly you're telling? So okay, tell me this one, which is this one? Light blue, above that United States.
So Canada.
Okay, but without label, it is tough for me to say that. Okay, so what I will do? Let me drag the country to the labels here. Can you see here? Label something called as label here. It is there, Noma. Just
yes,
drag
sir.
The country to the label. Can you see now? It is labeled. Now it is easy for me to say which is Canada, which is United States, and which is UK, France, and all. And then even the amount is not labeled here now, right? So let me label once again. Which one? Amount also I want to label it. Is that clear now? Now what I will do, little font size, font little I will expand, big. Just click on the label and make me the font style little bigger so that it will be easy to see that. So can you see this now? You are getting this screen, ma? I think this is what we have done in our last class, right? Have everyone got this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. Okay.
So yes, sir.
Let me ask you one more small question in this place. So what I wanted, let me change the map visualization like this. Let me change like this. This one, I selected this one. So from amount from starts from zero and ends at about 260K, appear 26,000, 2 lakhs, something. All these amounts are showing for me. I have a small question. What is that question? Is nothing but here. Show me the amount exported for all country I told, right? So next one more question. Show me the amount exported only to France. So here, now what you do, right? On the left side, so where actually France is there? In measures or dimension? Little loud, ma.
Sir.
Dimension. Okay. Under dimension? Under which dimension? What type of category we have? Under country, right? So drag and drop that country into the filters in the left side here. So automatically you are getting filter country. We can do this with one more tool also, like fix. There is something called as fix, the spinning tool here. Which one? Let me enable the note. Wait. Using this also we can do it, but that and all later I will tell you. So now, you are in this screen. You got a dialog box like this. Now what you do? You select only France. And just click on apply and okay. This is the amount exported for only France. Totally how much? On the left side, I have something called as product. Let me drop the products also here. Like this, product into rows. So apple for how much on the France country, country in the France and product, banana for how much, for beans how much, broccoli, everything we'll be getting. And product, I will label it here. Is that clear, ma? So actually, this is what we have done in the last class, a small demo about while we are working with the Tableau software. Are you getting this one? Is there any problem getting in this screen? Please respond.
No, sir.
You received. You are getting this. Good. Okay. Now, okay. 1 second. The participants list. I will take it. Actually, I'll take attendance list from Afsan to Rohi. Print screen. One and from Rohi to okay. I've taken the attendance. Okay. So now this is what we have done in our last class. So now, as of now, you just minimize the software. Okay. So what? Still we are not entered deeply into our Tableau software. We are going to do orderly, right? Because still we don't know how it saves, in what type of format it gets saved, and where it will be saved. Many things, the basic things we have to learn still. Okay, so we'll go order and we'll do touch that also. Now, what I will do as of now, let me close this here. Can you see here? Can you see a small tool here? Close this dashboard. Just close this. And after closing this dashboard, come back to data source. Okay, let it be like this. Minimize this. Or you keep it, not a problem. You're attending, right? You just keep it. So now what I will do, I'll go further. Okay, now, so we're going to see something about Tableau. Tableau was founded in Mountain View, California in January 2003 by Chris Stoll and Christine Chabot and Pat Handhorn. And we have seen that why Tableau use. Tableau helps the world's largest organization, which is used for data organizations with their data and with their peoples. And which is Tableau use empowers users to see and understand their data. Okay, it harnesses people's natural ability to spot visual patterns quickly, revealing everyday opportunities in endocrine moments alike, however we are working now. Okay, and it allows the customers to spend more time on data analysis and less on data wrangling. So data analysis means, we know what is data analysis, right? There will be large data, however we want, we can take that data based on the criteria or conditions, what they given, we will analyze that. So we will be working on that more. And we'll be working less on wrangling. Wrangling means how, where we have to customize that, how we have to import that, from what type of software we have to import, any other softwares we have to download or install. All this will be reduced. Just we'll be working on analyzing that and then visualizing that. Okay. Now, next. So I think I given a small intro about products of Tableau in last class, right? So which one we are using? We are using Tableau's desktop, our server, our Tableau online, our public, our Tableau reader.
Tableau desktop.
Very good. You are using Tableau desktop. So what about server? I told in the last class. So okay, you need any time or some time to take notes for this, to write down. Are you got any time to write down this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you tell me, miss, I'll give some time where you can take a note of the slides. Okay, if you want to take, just tell me that. Okay, I'll give some time. You take, and then once finished, you tell me. Okay, now, so first have note about this one. Take a note of this one. It can be like a screenshot or writing, whatever, fine. Done? Once you're finished with taking notes, you can tell me, ma. Who are taking notes? Who is copying now? Finished, da?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Done.
Okay. No. Just I should have confirmation you're taking right. So you should tell me. You take your own time, not a problem at all. Okay. So next one. So the why we use Tableau. So Tableau is used to access multiple data connections. I think already I told you, we can access whatever type of files. Means data may be stored in Excel format, or data may be stored in that notepad format, in SQL format, okay, in Amazon server database, or MySQL format, or any other based connections format, okay. So, but Tableau is used to act as one ability to access any data. It has access to connect any data, multiple data connections. And at a time, you can connect how much you want. So Tableau connects easy to nearly any data source, be it corporate data warehouse, Microsoft Excel, or web-based data. Let it be whatever type of data, it can be accessed easy. And then we have something called as live analysis. So live analysis means, let me give a small example. You know Times of India, right? On the election time, when election polling times and all, they will be using Tableau softwares only. Actually, if I want to say, most of the press means Times of India, any other things you know, ma? Another that Times of India?
Hindu.
Yeah, Hindu. Most of the newspaper companies, they use Tableau softwares. Why? Because they will be doing live analysis. Why? In our COVID time also, they will be uploading that. There will be an access. They will be having a server, live server connection. Okay. They will be uploading the data as an Excel. Okay. This many cases in Bangalore, this many cases in Mangalore, okay, and this many cases in Udupi, like that. They will be uploading that entries, this much new cases queued, okay, pending cases. They'll be keep on uploading that in the database. Okay, what they will do is they'll be having a live connection to their database. So once they make changes, automatically for us also it will be replicated. We can see that in our news channels, automatically it will be increasing, decreasing. So there is nothing but called as live analysis. What peoples they use in the election time and this type of situations when we are having COVID and all, how they analyze this many cases are increased, automatically this much cases are decreased, means with the help of the Tableau only. Where the television peoples, miss news channels, they will be using this. So Tableau allows you to connect to your live data and perform various analyses on it. They will be uploading based on that. I will be filtering something and I will be showing for you on my news channel. Okay, so they'll be showing how many males, how many females are that, okay, in which places, exact locations and all, they'll be uploading in Bangalore. So for example, JP Nagar, Marathalli, 5 cases in JP Nagar, 5 cases like that, they will be uploading. But as a news channel, what I will be doing is, I don't want like, means I'm doing, showing like all over the world or in India, entire India. At that time, I can't focus on Marathalli, JP Nagar and all, right? So what I will do, I will remove, means they will be uploading. I will be removing that. I'll be taking based on cities or state or country where we have options in the tableau, right? We have, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So let me show that once where we have that. So how you want geographical view? So in the country and region, once you go for sheet view, okay, so you can take here what type of locations you want. So it's a state deep. If you go, means you'll get the states, everything, means states, means countries, everything you'll be getting. So this is the place and where you can mention that in this place also, the dashboard. City, district, country, state or provisions, based on province and based on zip code and postal code, and where are the airports are there, area codes of US. So based on this, suddenly if I select city, inside that country, cities will be located. It will be showing which city. Okay, so that and all deeply will be taken. So they'll be uploading city, and city comes under which country, region or everything. But I want to show for you in the format of country, means so automatically we will change it here so that it will replicate for you in a different format. So these are all, everything runs based on Visqure. Okay. And okay, so one small question. What is that SQL stands for? Okay, what's that VSQL stands for? Anyone? What is that VSQL stands for? Sorry. Anyone who has unmuted the mic? Hafsan, Kansha, Ananya, Akita, Bhavana, Vinita.
That is it. Is in query language.
A little loud, ma. Visual query language. Okay. SQL means structured query language. Got. So that is the difference. So we use VSQL or SQL to the Tableau software. Which one we are using? VSQL or SQL?
SQL.
VSQL. But that means we don't have SQL in Tableau. We have SQLs and ODB connectors and all by default. But Tableau is working based on VSQL. Okay. Okay, now next. So that is what I was telling before only. Maps. Most tools requires an extreme amount of work to make map data works correctly. Tableau made it pretty seamless. So what does that mean? You can see last class we have seen something in the Excel. Country automatically loaded, right? So in that if I want to make like state or region, we had little problem. Why? Because we don't have the things in that place. And I zoom, I will be getting. But we don't have a option directly to change that in the Excel. But in Tableau, it is very easy and they made it very easy for us, where I just click and how I want city or region or country or however I want based on postal code. They made it everything very easy for us, right? So this is what, why we use Tableau, the reasons why we use Tableau software. Okay, so you need time to take this notes. Yes means just tell me and take the notes and tell me once finished. Don't worry, we are not yet deeply went into the Tableau on practicals. Okay, we have to go slowly, we have to understand which every tools, why we use, how we have to use. Then finally, once we enter a third or fourth session deeply into the practicals, at that time, everything will be fine. So until that, we will be seeing like the simultaneously practical and a little bit of, practical and little theory. So which makes you to understand. So who is taking notes? Tell me, ma, once it is finished. If no one is taking notes, not writing, or if you're taking screenshot, not a problem. Tell me that. But however, class recordings are available. Anyone opened? How many views? How many of you viewed the last class sessions? I think I uploaded in the group.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's
all. Okay. How many? No. Wow, good. 9 views are there. Good. So remaining and all, they'll be seeing, I think. Okay. So next, we'll go for another concept. Products of Tableau. Already we went once through that, but take a brief note on this. Okay. So once if you're confused about what is the desktop, what is a server, online, public, reader, what products I have to take, which I have to download, I'm getting confused and sad. Means first you know what is a desktop, what is public, what is server. Then you'll be getting a clarifications when you're downloading or when you're suggesting for someone which you have to purchase. It will be easy. Tableau desktop is the authoring and publishing tool that is used to create shared views on Tableau server. Tableau desktop only what we are using and where individual person as a client I can use. And where I can create it and I can publish that into the shared views and I can publish that to the server also. As an individual, I can create that. Even I can share to others. I can share it on server also. I have permissions for everything. But I can work on that. Okay. So no one can access my Tableau, my software. They can't take remotely and they can't work. Means they can access my computer remotely. Means I can't authorize any others come into my Tableau software. You have a one more account in my software and you work. I can't assign one more account for them having the desktop version of Tableau. Is that clear? Okay. So before that, let me explain you what is server and client. Anyone have any idea about what is server and client? Okay, now this is server, you think. Okay, and we have something called as clients. These are all clients. So basic example, I'll tell you how you know about what is server and client and all like that, I'll tell you. So assume that this is Tableau server. Okay, server means where I can give. So for example, let me take five names list. I have Swan, search AN. and here another name, AKANKSHA, and another Ananya, ANAYA. Ankita. Okay. So, for example, you are from US or someone from France, and you are from UK, and you are from India. Okay. So, can you see this diagram? Is it visible to you? Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So now what happens when I have Tableau server, I can give you a user account and password. I'll give you a username and password, right? Because I want a Tableau server. Okay. So then where I will give for you one username and password. So having, I will create an account for you in my server. Server means where more number of people can connect to the server and they can work at a time. I will create a username for you and I'll give a ID and password to you. So whenever you want, you can log into my Tableau server and you can take data from the server and you can load data to the Tableau server also. And what is the advantage means? I will be giving scheduling also. For example, tomorrow 7 o'clock, automatically the data will be distributed for all four of you. Okay, and automatically it will be visualized at 7 o'clock by default for all of you based on the data what you sent. So where I can make time sense also there. Okay, I can make time sense at this time. You have to automatically submit your data or I will give data for you. So many things, and at a time you can load data to Tableau and Tableau will handle all your accounts by being from one place. Means Tableau Server Editions. See here, Tableau Server is a business analytics platform that can scale up to thousands of users. But I draw something for users, but it can scale up to thousands of users. It is mainly designed to publish, store, and schedule automatic refreshes on the web. Okay, so automatically, I have a Tableau Server, as I told you, you upload your stock items. Okay, so whatever they are uploading, I have shared that on the web. On my web, I have shared. Okay, so from different country, when you are uploading, my Tableau server will take the data and automatically it will publish on the web. Okay, why? Because 1,000 people are sending that different data. Okay, I can analyze that. Okay, I can visualize and I can upload on that web. So this is nothing but called as server, where 1,000 people can work at a time on our Tableau server. And what is Tableau Online? Is hosted in cloud version of SaaS, SaaS. It is online. Okay, so where cloud-based is nothing but called as Tableau version, cloud-based one. You know, right? Cloud computing, cloud-based and all. So this is not just for cloud one. And Tableau Public is a free product from Tableau, allowing visualization enthusiasts to play with data and with some restrictions. Okay, last class I told some word. We are using 14 days trial period of which version? Desktop version. We have any restrictions here? In the version what we are using, desktop versions?
No, sir.
No, right? Okay.
No.
So, but what is public means? Here, I'm going to explore some data on the public. I'm using Tableau public version. I can't save that into my computer, means in my hard disk. I think last class also I told. I told the same thing. I can't save it in my documents or desktop. So, it will be in cloud only. Public means where I can't save that Tableau workout file or work file into my computer. It will be public and everyone can see that on the web, and even you will be having a different account when you sign in for a public version. They will give a different login ID and password, and your workout will be publicly also shown, and you can also see in others. But the problem there, you have some restrictions, and where you can't download that to your computer. This is the problem there. And next, Tableau Reader is a free application that lets anyone view and interact with Tableau packaged workbooks. Only views what? Tableau packaged workbooks. Okay, so Tableau Reader. So why we use PDF Reader? Have you know PDF Reader, right? You know PDF Reader?
Yes, sir.
We used to read PDF files, right? So same thing, see here, we have something called as Tableau Reader. I think the file has got downloaded. One second. This one. So where you can download, let me tell you. Table AU / products / reader. You type like this on the web where you can have Tableau Reader version of software. Okay, just to view that file. Just it is used to view the file where you can download this. It is free. Okay, you can download that, and where which is used to read the file. Having something error. Okay. So now let me go for another concept. Is it clear until for here, everyone? What is Tableau Desktop? What is Tableau Server? Online, public, and reader? Okay. So next, we'll go for another one. So same thing only. Next, we are going to see Tableau Architecture. We're going to see Tableau Architecture. So how the Tableau actually works, or it's built in, everything we are going to see here. See here on the left side, these are the list of data sources. Actually, I told everything already, how it works and all. Same thing once again, I'm explaining. So these are the list of sources from where I'm getting the source. I'm getting some source from the MySQL, from SQL Server, from Oracle, SAP, Teradata, SAS, okay, Twitter, Microsoft Dynamics, Notepad, Access, Excel. All of them are giving their data, source data, whatever the records are, they're right. In that format, in that software format, they'll be giving to us. So next, here we are having two things. One is Tableau Desktop, and one more is Tableau Server. And here you see, and we have two types of connections already we have seen. One is extract and one more is live. So extract, what happens? It takes this data and it stores in between a place called as TDE. What is TDE means? What is TDE, Ma?
Tableau Data Extract.
Tableau Data Extract. Okay, so that data will be extracted and it will be kept in this place. And from there, it will be imported to the desktop. Tableau Desktop means the Tableau applications. And then it will be published. And it can be published for Tableau Readers and Tableau Static Readers. It can be published as Excel, it can be published as a PowerPoint or a PDF or in any other format, or it can be published for mobile phones users or laptop or web users, any of them. Okay, this is what extract. But live means we are having a direct interactions between that source and that Tableau software. So directly from Excel to Tableau. So in between, we are not having anyone between that database, data source and desktop versions, Tableau softwares. So we are having a live connections. When I make changes here, it updates here. But is it possible? Means I'm telling frequently, when I change that, any changes in data source, it gets changes in the Tableau. Is it possible to change or edit the query or data sources in the Tableau? I'm not told, but simply I'm asking. Is it possible to edit the data inside the Tableau software? Just you can guess and tell me. Is it possible or not to edit the data? You're understanding my question?
No, sir.
You're not understanding my question. See,
no, sir.
You can't. Okay, very good. Actually, you can't edit that. Basically, what you can't? You can't edit inside Tableau. You can't make any changes for your data source, which is imported to the Tableau. It can be only edited when it is there in the their data source, means their source file. And the source file open with the source softwares. Once it is imported into the Tableau, it cannot be edited. We can't make any changes to that values. And this is Tableau desktop. And the same well as here, this is Tableau server. So in Tableau server also, we are having the extract methoding and we are having live method also. But here what happens? We have something called a security. What is security means? So where I am having the Tableau server software in my system or in my company, in my place and my laptop, where I have given access for you people. I told right that time I have drawn 5 diagrams for 5 people, right? I have given access to you where I can manage security also for you. So at what time you can access, what type of data and all you can access in my server. Okay, and if you want to access my my server is linked with Amazon, Flipkart, different databases, and you are working in my server, having an account, you are working in my Tableau server. So I have data in my server, Amazon server, Oracle database, SQL, MySQL database and all. If you want to access my SQL data source, okay, so I can give security. So where Afsan cannot access SQL database, where Ankita cannot access Amazon database, I can assign security for you peoples. Clear? And then where whatever the data's everything loaded, it will be loaded in cache memory. Okay. And then after loading into the cache memory, that workbooks, whatever we are creating that workbooks, right? Into the Tableau softwares, everything will be stored into Tableau repository place. We have something called as Tableau repository. I will show you that where the Tableau repository. Okay, wait. See, come down, open your file, Tableau software. Okay, wait. Minimize this Tableau. So open my computer and go for documents. Open my documents. Can you see any word like that? My Tableau repository. Anyone? Open my computer and open my documents. Can you see anything called as my Tableau repository?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So there it will be stored. Under that, you will be having something called as data source. Okay. Inside that version, here you will be getting stored. I'll be telling this, what is TDS, what is Excel, what is this hyper, okay, and another, all this, everything I'll be telling this. Connectors, what and all we are using, okay, and log files. I'll be explaining you this, don't worry about this. Okay, everything I'll be telling this. KPI also one of an important one. Okay, so but, so just know that where you have Tableau repository, where this is the place everything will be get stored. The connectors, data sources, extensions, logs, maps, services, shapes, workbooks. Everything will be stored in these places. That is what it is showing here. Store workbooks in something called as Tableau repository. And then what is this management automation? Management and automation. So nothing but scheduling. I'm scheduling. Already I told you, I can schedule you at 7 o'clock. Automatically means at every morning 7 o'clock, automatically that visualization will be appeared in my web page. I can schedule timings every day morning 7 o'clock, automatically upload the visualization of yesterday's report on my server or in my website or in my host page somewhere. So where I have something scheduling management in the server also. These are the difference when I'm working with the server. Is that clear for everyone? What is the difference between the server and desktop versions? Security, okay, repository, management and automations. And something we have separately cache memories to store that. And after that, as usual, we can view that in the Tableau readers, static and web and mobile users. Is that clear for everyone, Ma? Okay. The same thing you see here. One more. Next level of Tableau server architecture. Okay. Once it is 5:30, you remind me once. Okay. We'll go a small practical file for today's concept. Why? Because first, we have to know theoretically about Tableau. Okay, so directly everything, if you went practically, we will not understand some things. So we'll go something practically and theoretically, and I'll give some assignment also for next class. Okay, so just you remind me at 5:30. That's it. What is the time exactly now? It's 5:12, I think. Okay.
12.
Yeah, good. So exactly, remain at 5:30. Let's have a 5 minutes break and I'll start the practical. So now you can, you see this diagram. Data sources, customer data. Customers are giving data to me. Where such type of called as data warehouse, data warehouse, data marts, and like notepad or other files. It's a notepad file and cubes. Customers are giving me. Okay, I'm a project manager. Okay, I'm working based on Tableau software. My customers are giving data. Different people are giving different data to me. And give me a visualization where and which country and which place, what product more getting sold. Give some visualizations for me. So for that, they're giving the data to me in different format. Data warehouse, data marts like this. So server components you see in the middle, data warehouse as a data connector called as fast data engine. Data warehouse as a data connector. So which makes a connections, connectors. Connectors, how can you explain connectors? I have a C-type charging pin. I have phone, which is C-type, but I don't have C-type pin. I can use one more connector in between, right? Which makes another charger connects into C type connector, what we use, right? So like one of a connector is called as this data connectors, fast data engine, are used as a connectors which makes a connection between the data sources and in my application users or through the data server. Data connectors makes a connection between the data warehouse and my data server. And data marts, data marts use an SQL connector, structured query language. And files, it also directly imports. And cubes use MDX connectors. And another thing, when you are extracting, we use something called as repository. Clear? Okay. Now, main components we are using is nothing but called as three servers we are using. Mainly, how many servers we are using? Three servers. One is data server, and one more is VSQL server, and one more is application server, which is very important to work in the Tableau software. We know exactly it is VSQL software. We'll be seeing that everything deep. What is VSQL? What is application server? What is data server? But if I go linearly, everything deep into theory, you'll be getting bored. Okay. Next, gateway. Gateway load balancer. So whatever way you are giving 1,000 records, 2,000 records, you are giving more records. But that gateway load balancer balances the load what you are giving, or what that server or data sources load it is giving, right? It will balance the load. Load balancer used to balance the load, and then it makes as a visualization as a desktop or a mobile or a browser view as a user and application. For clients, we can make it in this type of views. So data source and using server components, and then user applications view. So this is a process running in the Tableau server architecture. Okay, these are all theory, depth knowledge about that. Okay, in between, we will attach that, not a problem at all. Okay, so now I'm having a small question to you. Question one and question two. Can you see the questions? Anyone? Okay. So take 5 minutes break and think for these two questions. Let's have a small break. It's around 5:17. Let's have 2-3 minutes break. And you also have a break. Have some snacks or some water or something. Okay. And think about these two questions. And let me come back at 5:20. Okay. Is it okay for everyone? By the time, just
yes, sir.
Yeah, just think what is the answer for the two questions. After that, let's answer me. So I'm back. Everyone are there? So what is the answer for the first question? What is or the benefit of the data visualization? Option A or option B or option C or option D?
Sir, D.
Okay.
Option D, sir.
Palak, okay. Option D. One more, others? One more voice I got.
Option D.
Option D.
Option.
Okay, very good. Exactly. Everyone's answers are right. It is option D. Okay, what is that? Question two. Which query language is supported by the Tableau?
Sir, option A.
Okay.
Option A.
Option?
A.
Option A.
Everyone are saying option A. Any other answers, tell me, except option A. Anyone are there?
Option D.
Option D, who's that? Who's that option D?
Sir, Akamsha.
Ah, option D. Exactly, you're right. It's option D. Why? Because actually Tableau supports VSQL, but SQL we can add as a connector in the Tableau. You told right, SQL works means Tableau works based on what? VSQL. Okay. So we are asking actually supported by. Supported by means working based on what anta. I'm not asking it will support anta. Okay, it's supported by. Okay, so it's supported. Well, totally Tableau is working only based on VSQL. So option A answer is, sorry, first question answer is option D, and second question option is answer D. So which query? So why visualization query language VSQL is used in the backend of Tableau as it creates a visual representation of your data right away, giving you visual feedback as you analyze. Am I right? You can write down this notes. Why? Because it are interview questions. It's are important in the interviews. Anyone, if you want to make a note, you can take a note. Anyone want to take notes?
Done.
Okay. Okay, so it's time we'll go on working a small practical. So before, I'm going to do something called as practical about join. We're going to practical doing about what? Join. There are three things called as join. Inner join. Okay, left join and right join. So before that, let me take one Excel file. Take a sheet. And let me take MS Paint also, because we require this also. File and new. So here, this is a column one, sorry, table. So this is nothing but table one. And under table one, I have column one. Assume that this is a table. Under this table, I have one column. The column contains 1, 2, 3, 4. This is very easy. I hope you would have studied in the maths. Something called as union, intersection by name that. Table B. And here I have one column. And here I have something called as 5, 6, 1, and 7. Okay. And we have something three. One is inner join. Okay. One more is left join. One more is right join. So first, let's talk about inner join. Something I'll make it done this. I'll make one more. Okay, I'm planning to do it straight, but it's not coming straight. Yeah. So now this is table one. This is having 1, 2, 3. And here, where it is having 5, 6, 1, and 7. So here, inner join means which are common in the both from the left table 1 and table 2. So table A or table B or table 1 or table 2. And here in table 1, I have one column where I'm having 1, 2, 3, and 4. And table 2 also, where I am having something 5, 6, 1, and 7. So when I'm using join in Tableau, I'll do particularly show that. Okay. So we are having something like 1, 2, 3, 4. So which are common in the both table 1 and table 2?
1.
Okay. Answer that. So you're telling. So that is nothing but 1, right? Okay. So this is nothing but called as what? Inner join. This place is nothing but called as what? Inner join. So which are common records between the two different columns or between two different tables or between two different queries? This is nothing but called as what? Inner join. And left join means, so where left join means, let me take one more example. One more this thing. And again, one more. Okay. So left join is nothing but where I'm having here 1, 2, 3, 4. And this side I'm having 5, 6, 1, and 7. So left join is nothing but left and which is common also. What will be the value? Left join is nothing but from the left column and which is joined, means combined, common value plus left table. Table 1 and common value. So what will be the answer here? Means for example, I'm telling this. Inner left is nothing but the left one. This one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Oh, no. Once again, tell me. See the diagram. 1, 6, 1, 2. Left ma, only left. Left and common. Which is left, which is highlighted? Tell me the answers once again loudly. Maybe I not realize properly.
Sir, 1, 2.
Once again. Okay, here the common value is 1. So, okay, tell me 1, 2. Then Hello. Can you able to hear me?
Sir, 3 and
3 and 4. Again, we have what? Common value as 1, right? In this middle?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So that also will be considered here. 1. That also will be considered. But so however, it will be checking. So this is getting matched. No. Miss this one with this one. And 1 with 5, 1 with 6, 1 with 1. Okay, here it says, yes, it is getting matched like this. And 1 with 7, remaining and all, no. So then, this one and with this one, it comes here, join. Okay, it left to join. Inner join means when it says yes, only this value will be taken, which is common. And right means on the right side. So can you say what will come for right one? Right join?
5, 6, 1, 1. 5, 6, 1, 1, 1, 7, 1 and 7.
Right? Yeah. So here also we have the common value what? 1, right?
1.
Yeah. So here two values we have common. Okay. So how actually Tableau calculates that means actually I have the value is 1. Which is repeated 2 times. So nothing but called as 1 into 2. It is nothing but called as curtain multiplication in Tableau. It is called as what? Curtain multiplication in Tableau. So one which is repeated, this or which is common value and which is repeated 2 times. So 1 into 2 is nothing but 2. This multiplication method is nothing but called as in Tableau, curtain method of multiplication. Clear? Okay. So now we will work fractal for this one. So once I will show you from my side and I will give the question to you and you have to do that and you have to send me the screenshot or you have to copy, take a screenshot and paste into the MS Word application in order assignment 1, assignment 2, assignment 3. After doing that, take a screenshot and you have to send it to me in the group. Is that clear? Okay, I'll show you that. How that also you have to do that. What is this? Okay, now let's everyone open the Tableau software. Close whatever the existing connection is there here. Open the first. Have your means. You're having the same exact screen. How I'm having, like this Tableau pivot and with this data.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now remove this one. File, close this one and file, click on the file, close the existing one. Again, then click on Microsoft Excel. And have you downloaded the one more file what I sent? Sample superstore.xls file?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just please select that, ma. Just select it and open it. Selected, ma. You're getting like screen like this. Sample superstore. So this is nothing but that query name or the database name. You can rename this also, not a problem here. Something like this. You're in the screen and you're having like 6 sheets with 3 tables. Orders,
yes, sir.
peoples and returns, and just click on that orders and view this and see how the data are there. Once category about, it's about 9994 rows having category city, country, customer ID, customer name, order data, order ID, product. And let me close this and let me check people also. People like person, four persons and from four regions. Okay, close.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, tell me, ma'am.
Sir, can you please repeat it once again? How to select the, like, the other data source?
Oh yeah, one second. Yeah, let me do. Again, click on file. Let me close this. Unknown source. So again, file, close. So yeah, you open like this. Okay. So first, download the file from the WhatsApp group. Have you downloaded? It's there. Which one? This one. You download it. So once you download, means it will be saved in the downloads. Make sure that where it has been saved, most probably in downloads. Then click on the left side to a file. Just click on the Microsoft Excel. Okay. So you'll be having in the downloads. I will be searching in the documents. Click on this documents. Come down. Select that sample superstore.xls. And just click on open. Now you're getting. Waiting. Good. So now, can you see that left side three sheets? Orders, people, and returns. So actually, now we are going to work on union. I'll tell you to. Why? Because in version what we are using. Actually, in previous version, it was easy. But the version what we are using currently now, it is little difficult. Why? Because we have to exactly do the drag and drop, or else you will not get that one. So now you are in this screen, right? So first, drag and drop that orders to this place. You are getting like this. Just drag the orders to the data source data. Once everyone are done with this, please tell me.
Sir.
Yeah. So then just click on this, double click on this. You'll get like this. When you double click on this table here, in this place order is the right. You just double click here. You'll be getting open with a dialog box like this. Order is made of one table. You're getting like this. Yeah. Now come to the left. Just take the people and bring on the right side and keep like this. Like this. I'm not leaving. I'm just holding. See, bring the peoples from the left side. People data and bring next to the orders. Don't do like this here. All here. Bring next to this orders. Nearly to this like this. Then leave that. Done?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now can you tell me what type of join it is? There are three join, right? Can you tell me what type of join it is?
Sir, inner join.
Very good. Inner join. What that inner join does? Inner join of orders and peoples. Region equals region peoples. So from the orders and from the peoples, from two different records, I have something common, means by default, it has taken what? Region. Region is nothing but which one is common. See here, region and region people. You click on this blue color here. Just click on this inner join, blue color. You'll be getting this one. Inner join, left and right, and full outer. Having this one, you are in this screen. Now inner, you know what is that? So it combines orders and people. Who is common in two things? Okay, that will be viewed. It is saying like region here. If you know something is there, other something common in both of that, just you can click on this arrow mark. You can choose this from this list. City or category or something. City I choose. Nothing. Nothing is there. Something country? No. Nothing is there. Region I have. So that's what automatically it has taken. If you have the, if you have something others, you can take that. Is that clear what is inner join now? Practically?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Now just click on the left join. What is left join? Just place the cursor and read that. Includes all the values in the left table. Everything from the left table. That means what? Everything from the orders table. And additionally, which is common from the right side. Okay. Includes all values from the left table. And all matches from the right table. Which matches to the left table from the right table. Only that much, everything will be combined and it will be shown here. Members without matches will show up as nulls on the right. So if you have something members, they are getting without matches, that will be shown as null value here. Something here means it will be showing something null. We don't have any null values here. Is a TF format. Again, as usual, right join includes all values in the right table and all matches from the left table. For that right people's table, which are getting matched from the left side orders, only both will be combined and it will be merged here. And what is full outer one? Together everything combines and merges, it shows here. Is that clear? Anyone have any doubts? Yeah. So this is a first practical assignment you have to send me. So first you have to import these two datas. You have to send me a report of inner join. Do inner join. Take a screenshot. If you don't know how to take a screenshot, and if it not works in your keyboard, so that start button pass break is not working in my keyboard. Okay, if you think something like, click on the start button, type sniping tool, take sniping tool, click on new, select this to this much. Okay, and save this as assignment one. Assignment one, and then insert that into a Word file saying that assignment one. I'll show that final view out should be there. But this is how to take screenshot if the shortcut keys in your laptop or desktop is not working means. You can use sniping tool. Clear? And same way.
So can we take the picture on the phone?
Yeah, that is also fine. Take the picture on the phone and insert that into that Word file and send me. But final result, how I want, I'll show you that. You have to return me like that. And question also I'll give you. And this left. And for right one and fuller outer one. Everything you have to show me once. But let me now let it default in. And then. Okay. Wait a second, just a minute. I'm getting a small message. Clear? So now just click on the sheet at the bottom, enter into the visualization. You entered? The first four, what is given is inner joint, left joint, right joint, and outer fit. Four assignments. And another one assignment is this one, what you have to do. Have you entered into the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what I want, show me the report based on order ID and sum of sales. Okay, show me the sales based on the order IDs. How much sales has done based on the order IDs? Just you show me a report for that.
Sir, where are we supposed to send?
Which one, ma?
Sir, where are we supposed to send the assignment?
Assignment, huh? You have to send me in the WhatsApp group. In the WhatsApp group, you have to send that. Okay. So now what you do, just drag and drop that order date into the columns and sum of date. One second, where is that sum of date? Okay, sum of sales is here. So, and then, so this is a report, nothing but based on the date, sales amount. And then, category, and subcategory into the rows. So show me a report based on the category and subcategory on what, based on the date and time, how much sales has been done. Okay, show me the report, the categories and subcategories for how much it has been sold out based on the date and time. Is that clear? You can write the question also if you want. So the question is nothing but show me the report or show me the visualization for category and subcategories, sales based on category and subcategory. Show me the report for sales based on category and subcategory with having date and time. Is that clear? First, you try this. You are getting this one practically. Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you are getting the report here. So we are showing what? We are showing a report based on the categories and subcategories. So categories are listed here. Categories and subcategories based on 2011, 2012, 2013. The sales amount for how much has been shown. So this is a report what you have to submit me.
Okay, sir.
Clear? Done? Okay. So now, how it has to be attached into the MS Word? See like this. So this installation things we have done already last class. Solution one, connection established between the sales and products. It has to be done like this. Means your screenshot should be sent like this. We can attach into the MS Word, you can send. Why? Because if you send as a photo, it will be problem. And so which photo belongs to you, which assignment belongs to you, we'll be having a problem that. Hello? Hello? Yes, tell me, ma. Someone is asking something. Hello? Who's that? Okay, this is the first assignment. Okay, inner join, left join, okay, right join, and outer join also. And then this is what? Performing cross join and connected data set. Inside that. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
With the headings, sir?
Yeah, I think it will be better, right? If you visualize with headings. First, next, just inner joint report, outer joint report, okay, right joint report, and full set, and then our data visualization. Last one, cross.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So is that clear, right, for today's concept? Okay, just last 5 minutes are there. Please, everyone tell me, is there any doubt still? Anything needs to be clarified for anyone? Or everything are clear?
Clear.
Clear. Others? Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Clear. Got. Okay. So clear, you can, sir, do this, right? Practically, you can work on this, right? Good. So next class, I'll be telling that like still we have worked many things, but I have not explained still about how to save. Miss, you know how to save and all, but basically there is something called as extension, how that file will be saved and which format the file will be saved. What is the difference between this extension, okay? What are the other extensions are there? Where it will be saved? What is the difference between this? So these things and all we will see in the next class, okay? Because
yes,
it has,
sir.
The what is extension? Why? Because this, it plays a big role. Why? Because we have different type of files and all. Okay, that and all we will see in our next session with a different practical. So first three classes will go with a small introductions or with a practical file. Okay, so in depth with a data full into a company level, we will enter within 4-5 classes. Okay, so until that small practical files only will come in. These are all small one, but data are very big. With this, having this data will work out. Okay, I hope everyone are clear about today's session. Okay. So hope everyone will practice and send me that outputs in our group. Okay. So bye everyone. Take care. So let's end today's session. Shall we end the today's session?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Box. Okay. Bye everyone. So data's are there with you, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We have.
Yeah. Okay. Bye everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you.